Doug Fisher, you just heard a fighter. I'll keep this very short. You just heard a fighter tell another fighter, "I'm gonna chop your head off." Yeah. Stirverne told that to arreola. What do you think about that? We don't
hear
that.
Sounded like
day.
He meant it. I mean, it started out. Looked like Chris was kind of bored, like a lot of folks were so far with the presser. And Stirverne woke him up with that declaration. And it seemed like he wasn't going to say anything, because the first thing he said when he went to the podium, Stirverne, was, "I have nothing to say." Then he just thanked his crew, and it was a very low mumble, and then all of a sudden...
Barry White.
Yeah, he was kind of Barry White, and then all of a sudden...
Barry White to Jason.
He's, yeah, right. He gets a little bit emotional, and then he says, I'm gonna cut your head off, Chris arreola. And it woke Chris up. And when Chris got to the podium, you know, he spoke his heart. He spoke his mind like he always does. And I'm glad you said that. I'm a crazy motherfucker, and I'm happy to hear stuff like that, which makes fans happy. Because, like Chris said, I mean, with big guys, you want to see big punches, you want to see knockdowns, you want to see guys going for it.
So my last question: Chris arreola goes and takes care of business and beats Stirverne. Do you hear the first bit? For Klitschko,
I heard Dan Goosen say that the purse bid for Klitschko Povetkin was $23 million.
Can you believe that?
I don't. I got to go check that out. It's on.
That's,
well,
that's it's taking 75-80% of the purse.
You know, with the Klitschkos, they're backed by a big German network that, you know, in effect, kind of helps promote them. And so when they come up with money, if it was K2, I'm imagining it was K2 that won the purse bid, they got that money from the German network. So they do such great ratings.
You're right. More than the soccer
and they game. and they fill whatever arena that they fight in. And that's the network, by the way, that puts forth those pyrotechnics and those great that wonderful production value that you see with a lot of fights in Germany, and they take it to another level with the Klitschkos. That's the network that pays for that. It's not the promoter. You know, out here it's the promoter that pays for the bells and whistles and all that kind of stuff, which a lot of times you don't see a lot of bells and whistles.
Because they have to pay.
You don't see that huge concert level production value in a lot of American boxing fights. You know, like you get with the WWE or with the UFC, they do it big with the, you know, with the theatrics and all that. But they do that over there, and it comes from the network. So I'm thinking a lot of that money came from the network, if not all of it.
Doug Fisher's prediction for Stirverne arreola?
I think it's a tit-for-tat fight early on. I think they both hurt each other because Stirverne can punch. He's fast, got long arms. And Chris has been off a year, you know, so he might be a little bit rusty. But I think after he gets hit, you know, he's going to wake up a little bit, and after three or four rounds, he's going to warm up and let those combinations go. And I think he takes out Stirverne. I'm going to say middle rounds. I'm going to say fifth or sixth round.
There you have it, Doug Fisher. Thank you very much. Look out for me to follow him on Twitter at Dougie Fisher. FiesMoviePoint.com. I'm Lasik back reporting.